Disgraced influencer Andrew Tate has been indicted and will face charges of rape, human trafficking, and forming a criminal gang to sexually exploit women. According to Romanian officials, three others will also be charged in connection to human trafficking, including Andrew's brother, Tristan. A spokesperson for the Tate brothers confirmed their indictment to NBC News. Both brothers deny all allegations.
Finally, Andrew Tate has been officially indicted for assaulting and abusing numerous women. Tate and his brother Tristan will now have to face trial for their crime. So let's get into some of the details about that indictment. From The Guardian, the Tate brothers are accused of luring the women to Romania before exercising acts of physical violence and mental coercion, according to a translation of a statement from Romania's Directorate for Investigating Organized Crime and Terrorism. The alleged victims were later taken to buildings in Ilfov County in Romania, where they were intimidated, placed under constant surveillance, and forced into debt, according to the statement. The defendants then allegedly forced the women to produce pornographic content, which was shared on social media. Prosecutors in Romania have charged Andrew with raping one of the alleged victims, while Tristan has been charged with instigating others to violence. The BBC said a Romanian judge had 60 days to inspect the case and that the trial would likely take years. No start date for the proceedings was announced. And of course, in true Andrew Tate fashion, he immediately took to the internet and his legion of incels to desperately try to spin the story in his favor. He posted this tweet in regards to his indictment that says, "I'm sure this case has absolutely nothing to do with stealing my wealth, despite the fact that he's currently under investigation for tax fraud along with everything else. So that wealth that he has might not even be lawfully his in the first place." He also posted a long video compilation with the various allegations of abuse against soccer star Cristiano Ronaldo, as well as Neymar, Johnny Depp. So this was the caption from that video. It says, "Men, this isn't about me. This isn't about whether you like me or not. This is about all of us. Today it's me, tomorrow it's you. Nobody is safe from these lies." Although I think that most people who are not the perpetrators of human trafficking are safe from being indicted for human trafficking. Now, the problem for Andrew Tate specifically is that he's on camera admitting to doing all of these crimes. Here we have some voice memos that he sent to a woman who he sexually abused. And I want to give a warning now that they are particularly difficult to listen to.
"Am I a bad person? Because the more you didn't like it, the more I enjoyed it. I loved how much you hated it. Turn me on. Why am I like that? Why? I am one of the most dangerous men on this planet. Sometimes you forget exactly how lucky you were to get f***ed by me. Would you rather me pin you down and make you do things you didn't like? Or would you rather you didn't like that I was thinking I can do whatever I want to? That's what it is. I'm the smartest person on this planet. Are you seriously so offended I strangled you a little bit? You didn't pass out. Chill the out. Jesus Christ, I thought you were cool. What's wrong with you?"
Another case against Andrew Tate that you should probably know about is coming out of the UK. According to Jezebel, earlier this month, Tate received a legal letter from four women accusing him of sexual assault and physical violence, warning Tate of imminent legal action in London's High Court. As well as prosecutors in Romania are still investigating him for sex trafficking of minor girls, so underage girls, as well as I alluded to earlier, investigating him for tax fraud. So there still could be more charges coming down the line in Romania. Cenk and Andrew Tate continuously told everybody that these charges were never going to happen, and here they finally are.
Yep. So there's one of the charges that I have a little bit of an issue with. Ravana and I will talk that through in a second. But let's talk about the charges he appears to be very guilty of. So they'll go to court and they'll present all the evidence, but those were Trump-like confessions. I strangled you a little bit. So what? And you were complaining about it. In other words, you didn't want to be strangled. I strangled you against your will. It's going to be hard to get past when you go to court. That is rock solid evidence against you. The other one was worse. You know, I did it again. He's pretty much admitting right there that he gets sexual acts against the will of these women. And there's another word for that. It's called rape. And so anything that involves physical violence, confessions to physical violence, sexual assault, he's in a world of trouble. And it appears that they have plenty of that. And so anything related to human trafficking coercion, whether it's financial and otherwise, that are legally against the law in Romania and is part of the case of human trafficking makes sense. Again, world of trouble. The one part, Ray, that I thought was a bit questionable, and then let's talk through whether it's questionable or not, is mental coercion. Because a lot of things could be considered mental coercion. And you know, usually in a normal relationship, there's plenty of lying back and forth, both men, women, etc. And where do we draw the line on mental coercion? That one I'm a little uncomfortable with.
Yeah, so I've looked into this case today, and we discussed previously when I was on the show how he actually trafficked these women in the first place. It's called the loverboy method. I think there's a really big misconception as to how sex trafficking happens. It's typically not someone being snatched off the street by a stranger. In fact, that accounts for less than 1% of the cases. Almost all sex trafficking is perpetrated by somebody that the victim knows. And the way that Andrew Tate did it was to convince these women who he selected to be vulnerable targets. He convinced them that he was in love with them, gained their trust, and brought them to Romania after convincing them that they were going to be in a relationship with him. And then his intent was to force them into to be sex trafficked afterwards. That is not what they mean by the mental coercion. The mental coercion that they are discussing in this this indictment against him is him beating other women in front of these women, threats of that nature. It's actually not the manner in which he brought them over to sex traffic them, but the way that he manipulated them not to leave throughout the sex trafficking. Anything other than the actual physical violence is encompassed by the coercion, the mental coercion.
Yeah, okay, that is such an important clarification. And we had this discussion in the production meeting, and Ray looked into it more. I'm theoretically a lawyer, but Ray is actually going to become an actual lawyer. And so to me, what I was saying in the production meeting is, if he's saying like, oh, I love you, and that's how he tricks them, then a lot of dudes are going to prison, right? But listen to her clarification. That is really important. That is not what this is, right? Now, if it's mental, the legal standard for mental coercion in Romania is, I beat people in front of you and imply that I'm going to beat you as well. Okay, yeah, that's what I would call that here in American law is assault, because assault is both actually attacking someone and putting them in fear that you are going to attack them by saying it or exhibiting other actions. And that's what it seems like is the equivalent of mental coercion in that case. Does that make sense, Ray?
Yeah, it's along those lines. I will say though, it's really shocking and fortunate that he's actually being prosecuted by the Romanian government, because they've gotten a lot of attacks from organizations that try to address sex trafficking as a country that has had really lax laws on sex trafficking. In fact, Andrew Tate bragged on camera that he moved to Romania because it had significantly laxer rape laws. So it's massive that this is even moving forward, although it's going to take years for this prosecution to actually occur. At least things are changing in that country as far as their treatment towards women.
Yeah, I'm gonna say one last thing here. Look, it's not that the right wing is being targeted. It's that the right wing thought they were above the law. That's why both Trump and Tate would admit to shockingly illegal things, because they thought, what do you mean? We're white right wingers. No one's ever gonna prosecute us. We can do whatever we want. We can say whatever we want, and we never ever get prosecuted. Well, there was a lot of truth to that, but now apparently not. And by the way, Romania isn't America. I don't know the right wing, left wing dynamic at all. And apparently neither does Andrew Tate. So if he thought he was above the law because he's a white right winger in Romania, he found out otherwise. And if you go to a country saying, I'm coming here because I think the rape laws are more lax, that is about as dumb a thing as you could possibly say. And you would only say that if you felt massively entitled to break the law anytime you liked. And unfortunately, that's the impression that America and UK left him with, because it's true. Most of the time, wealthy white right wingers never get prosecuted.
Exactly. And despite what he's alleging, there's no deep state conspiracy to to prosecute him in the very right wing country of Romania.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.